I grew up out kind of in the middle of nowhere, out in the country. Where I live, there wasn't a lot to do per se, in like the living in a city sense. So you really made your own to do. I got really into like skateboarding, and I would see these skate videos that would be cut together, and you know, these sort of montages of great tricks and stuff. And I thought, well, we can make that, right? Like, we have a video camera. At the same time, I was actually playing in Photoshop a lot. And then I found out that you could actually like take things from Photoshop and put them in Premiere. So that was a real revelation for me that like, oh, it doesn't just have to be video or graphics. It can be like video graphics. There isn't really a line, you know? It's when you get into digital media like that, it kind of can be whatever you want it to be. On my very first day of Full Sail, I showed up to school with my roommate, and we're standing outside the class. And I hadn't been standing there for more than 2 minutes, and somebody walked up to me and said,
"Hey, I'm Nate."
And that was the first time I ever met Nate Howe. And we have been close, and we've cried together, and laughed together, and grown in our careers together, and it has been one of the more meaningful relationships I've had in my life.
Very quickly after meeting Chris, I could tell that he was a person that I wanted to be around. It is unbelievable to me what an impact he's made on my life. I mean, he is a trailblazer that showed me the path to getting out to Los Angeles. He helped me start my freelance career in Los Angeles. And from the moment I met him, he was interested in design and technology and interactive and all these things.
That was like a challenge for me. It was like figuring out which thing I was. People love to put things in buckets, right? Like humans do that. And so I always felt the need to put myself in a bucket. Like, what am I? Am I a motion designer?
Chris had every big studio trying to hire him. I mean, there were full-time job offers, freelance booking offers, flying left and right. And Chris then took that, all that knowledge, and he transcended that whole industry, and he said, you know, I want to do something more. I want to now bring this back and merge my love of problem solving and design with technology and interactivity and emerging markets. So he went up to Google and he impressed them just like he does everyone.
For the first time in my career, the more things I can do, the better I am as a designer. So I'm prototyping, I'm doing visual design work, I'm doing motion design, because really, design is just the ability to communicate concepts, right? Design is narrative. Design is the ability to tell a story. And the more tools you have in your tool set, the more powerful you can be at storytelling. The problems that I'm working on now are very hard. There are not foundational design patterns. There are not pre-existing mental models for people. And I see myself chewing on this problem for quite a long time. So many people that have supported me along the way, you know, meeting my wife and becoming not just a spouse, but a partner with her. You know, it's a lot of work with two kids. And seeing their curiosity and seeing the way they look at the world, no one has more empathy than kids. They're the world's greatest designers.
I'm so excited for him to be in the Hall of Fame, because he embodies on so many different levels what a successful Full Sail grad is.
My time at Full Sail uniquely prepared me for Google in a way that I didn't expect until like 17 years into my career. And the empowerment that it gave me to be in that environment, that, you know, that switch of like, this is a thing that I can do that will make a difference, didn't turn on in me until I came to Full Sail. You know, it's a really humbling and meaningful thing for me to be inducted, but really, it's mostly a great excuse to come hang out with everybody again.